blanks are shit. I mean, you go and ask anybody in the street, in anywhere in the country, and say, you know, have you got any love lost for the banks? They're going to say, absolutely not. You know, all they've done is shit on people.
To let, to let, to let. Everything's to let.
There's no money. There's absolutely no money here.
Across Britain, dreams are too often turned into nightmares, simply because of a lack of cash.
The banks aren't lending any money.
Of course, we put all our money into it now, and we contacted our banks to see if they could help us, but in the present circumstances, they can't do.
They just can't get the finance.
And I put all my art and everything into this. It's just the financial situation of the country, like, not lending.
But local man Dave Fishwick wants to fix things. He still lives just outside Burnley with his wife Nikki, where he fought his way up from builder's labourer to become the biggest minibus supplier in Britain.
But when the banking crisis struck, Dave's minibus business was threatened, and his customers could no longer get loans. He survived by lending his own money, and that gave him an idea.
If the big banks aren't lending enough money to people who need it, why doesn't he just start his own?
What would you type into Google to say, or to ask it, how to open a bank?
Why, instead of using the word bank, why don't you just say a money lending organisation or something like that?
FSA Compliance Consultancy Services for UK Banking Applications. That might be the one, chicken.
See, you just needed to ask, didn't you?
I did. That's what I needed, eh? Now then, who could I ring? Andrew, I've got a really, really exciting project that I'm taking on. I'm trying very, very hard to get in touch with Richard Branson himself. Hello, Simon. My name's David Fishwick. I'd like to speak to Mervyn King, please, at the Bank of England.
What, the number from Mervyn King?
Yes, please. He owns the Bank of England, or he runs the Bank of England. Thread, needle. My pen just went then. Isn't that annoying when it does that? Thread, needle, straight. And that's London. You haven't got the postcode for me sat nav, have you?
With a few meetings arranged, Dave heads to London to find out how he might set up his bank without taking years to do it.
Richard Branson might be on this. Can I have a quick chat to him about the banks?
With around 100 businesses failing every day in Britain, he needs to do it quickly.
What's your name? John. Hiya, John. I'm Dave. Marvellous. Looks like we're coming with you today.
I've saved this year.
Fantastic. Are you sitting with us, John? Sometimes it's far easier just to go and do something than try and get permission. It's far easier to apologise after. So sometimes you've just got to set off and do it, and I think that's what we're doing here today.
But banking is tightly regulated by the Financial Services Authority, and only one other brand new high street bank has been licensed in 100 years.
I'm definitely, definitely going to need some help filling this in. Hello there.
Britain's big banks now sell and sometimes miss-sell everything from insurance to investments, and gamble on everything from property to shares. Dave's hoping to go back to basics and bring the same no-nonsense approach he used to build his minibus empire to the world of banking.
This looks like it. Hello, everybody. Is this Zopa? Hello there. I'm David Fishwick.
Dave is in London looking for ideas and support. The first company he visits, Zopa, matches savers and borrowers through a website.
We do 95% of what banks do, with the exception of taking deposits. So we've managed to avoid the requirement for a banking licence. We do have various other licences, so we have a consumer credit licence from the OFT so that we can lend.
Now that's interesting, the consumer credit licence. Could I use a consumer credit licence to do 99% of what a bank does?
Yes, if you didn't take any deposits from consumers and you simply lent, for example, your own money, then you wouldn't need a banking licence. But the moment you start using the public's money to lend, which is after all what banks do, then you need a banking licence.
And is there a way around that in any way, shape or form? Is there a way around not needing the proper FSA banking
license? I don't think so, if ultimately you're going to be taking deposits.
The reason I'm doing this is I'm trying to make a difference. I'm trying to open a better bank. And I need to find a way around some of the regulations. The regulations are important, they're there for a reason, but the way you've done it, you've found a way around it. Perfectly legally, but you've found a way around it, and I need to go and find exactly the same way.
It's not so much finding a way around things, it's finding a way that what you do is not affected by regulation.
Yes, that's exactly right. In fact, that's so important, I should write that down. Thanks, everybody. See you later. Good luck. Bye-bye now.
The idea is fascinating, and the guy is so enthusiastic. I mean, he's a lovely guy. He's assuming that his force of character and some rationality will overcome rules, because that's the way entrepreneurs think. But because these rules weren't written for people like him, and the people who apply them aren't known for their flexibility, I think he's going to have a bit of an issue if he tries to go the whole hog and become a bank.
As an internet business, Zopa is miles from the old-fashioned high street style bank that Dave wants to set up. He wants to meet and advise his borrowers face to face and prove he can create a better bank.
The fit's atrocious. What size chest are you?
I'm getting the sense that you're a really nice guy.
That's very kind of you to say, yeah.
Now that's just very slightly worrying.
I love your pioneering spirit, Dave. I think it's great. First immediate reaction is, you've got no chance.
What you're planning to do there is
almost impossible.
It's too simplistic.
Yes.
Finally, at the end of the day, he reaches London's Mayfair and banking guru, Andrew Hilton.
Hello there. Is it Andrew?
Yeah, it is.
Hello, Andrew. Hi. I'm David Fishwick. Hi. Very pleased to meet you. Yeah, have you any tips or advice about how you think I could go about opening this tiny bank?
Probably go out and raise £50 million. If you go out and raise £50 million, it'll be reasonably easy to set up a bank.
Yes.
You got the money?
No.
Well.
What's the next best thing?
It's going to be difficult. You could start with a credit union, or you could start with a building society. That's possible.
So I could be 99% a bank without the bank license if I did it the building society way?
Maybe 60% a bank.
Why couldn't I call it a bank? Could I?
Because you're legally not entitled to call something a bank unless it has a banking license.
How would you go about it if it was me?
It's much harder than it used to be. When I was starting out, if you went to the right school and you had the right kind of parents, then maybe they would, you know, consider that you were a fit and proper person to go into the banking industry. Now they say, look, there are a whole bunch of exams that you've got to take.
Yes.
You've got to prove that you're a fit and proper person. There's no evidence whatsoever that you are.
Yes.
You know nothing about banking. You
yes.
haven't taken the exams.
Yes.
You can't just go in and say, oh, I want to be a banker. What kind of history do you have of running a bank?
Well, I've got no history at all, and that's probably one of the problems. You know, I sell minibuses.
You want something that is called a bank and you don't care so much what it does. I'm telling you, you can have a building society and you could do most of what a bank does. I would come to the opening, I'd shake you by the hand, I'd give you a kiss on both cheeks and tell you you've done good.
If I opened a building society?
If you opened a building society. If you open a bank, I would think, here's a guy who's really got ideas above his station.
I'm feeling fairly rubbish, to be honest. No, really, really disheartened by that. I'm not in his clique, that's for sure. You know, I'm not in the private schoolboy's clique, which all the bankers and the investors and all the rest of it probably are. That's not me. Just going to be an awful lot harder than what I thought. A million times harder than what I thought.